How do I create a new partition in Windows 10 or 11? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got some time ago. My C drive has 465 gigabytes and E reserve drive maybe 100 gigabytes. I do not have any unallocated space anywhere. Therefore, I cannot partition the hard drive. I want a partition with 100 gigabytes to put Windows and everything else for my data. So while I don't do it myself, many people prefer to partition their single physical hard disk into multiple hard disks. They'll have a partition for the operating system and a partition for their data. The theory is that by doing so, by separating operating system from data, backing up and restoring one or the other becomes easier. An update to the operating system doesn't necessarily affect your data, and so forth. I tend to play a different way, but that's fine. There's nothing wrong necessarily with using partitions this way. If you've got enough free space on your C drive, then creating another partition is actually pretty simple. I will show you the steps. So here we are in Windows 11. I'm going to bring up Windows File Explorer real quick just because I want to show you that my C disk here is 126 gigabytes and it's got 89.6 gigabytes of free space. So I can then use that free space to make a new partition. How do we do that? Well, we fire up the disk management tool, right-clicking on the start button and then clicking on disk management. It analyzes the file systems for a couple of minutes and then tells us what we've got. As you can see, disk zero, which is a single physical disk, has three partitions on it right now. It has an EFI system partition. It has my C drive, the actual partition that I see in Windows Explorer, and then a recovery partition at the end. Again, that C partition is 126 gigabytes. We can make it smaller. I'll right-click on it and click on Shrink Volume. It's going to analyze the partition in order to understand just how much smaller it can make it. It starts by showing me the defaults, which are to take all of the free space and make a new partition out of it. That's not what I want. What I want to do instead is I want to shrink it by, I'll just say, 50,000 megabytes, which is roughly 50 gigabytes. We'll hit shrink. It does its magic, and now all of a sudden, our drive has four partitions on it. Well, not really four partitions, three partitions and this unallocated space immediately after the C drive. So, unallocated space, we need to format it to make it look like a disk. Right-click on it, new simple volume. Next, we're going to use all of the space in that unallocated portion. In this case, it's 49,999 megabytes. Rounding and conversions actually take away from the absolute 50 megabytes. We'll hit next. Assign it the following drive letter. This is your choice. You can change it to another drive letter if you want to, or you can simply accept the default. I tend to accept the default. Then we're going to format it. NTFS is fine, actually is probably preferred for internal drives. The allocation unit size, not something you need to think about. The volume label, I actually recommend that you change this to something meaningful for you because it's going to appear in Windows File Explorer. So for example, I'm going to say data drive because that's conceptually what I might use this other drive for. A quick format is all we need. We don't need to enable compression. And after a quick summary, it formats the drive and mounts it. We now have drive F on our system. And in fact, if I fire up Windows File Explorer again, go back to this PC, you'll see we have our local disk, which now has 77 gigabytes of total space. Our data drive is now 48 gigabytes of, well, empty space because we haven't put anything there. What we've done is we've partitioned or split our C drive into two. The original C drive, containing the operating system and whatever else you plan to leave there, and then this other data drive that you can use for whatever you want. Like I said when I started, I don't necessarily see the advantage of a separate data partition as being overwhelmingly greater than the more efficient space use of a single partition and using folders to organize your data, but if for any reason you feel the need to split that C drive into two partitions, now you can. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/20623. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.